Well, just before Christmas, former governor of Mississippi, William Winter, passed away. He was 97. Many don't know that in addition to his political career, he was also a tree farmer. In tribute, we look back on that part of his life with this 2006 report from former Farm Week anchor, Leighton Spann.
In the feature segment, as we told you earlier, former Governor William Winter was honored Tuesday as the Mississippi Forestry Association Outstanding Tree Farmer of the Year. While most recognize him as governor, not many know of his lifelong affiliation with forestry. Some now fondly refer to him as Mississippi's most respected statesman, but everyone still addresses him as governor. Jackson attorney William Winter, who was governor of Mississippi from 1980 to 1984, is just as proud of the title tree farmer. He grew up in rural Grenada County. The 1,300 acres have been in his family since his great-great-grandfather settled the land in 1837. Governor Winter has owned the property since 1952.
I had grown up with an appreciation for trees. My father understood, long before a lot of other people did, the importance of growing timber. So during the Depression, it was the timber that saved us rather than the cotton. The timber enabled us to keep on raising cotton.
The view from the front porch of the Winter family homestead, still standing on the property, is of a former cotton field now planted in pine trees. The house is no longer a residence, but serves as a lodge for a hunting club that leases the property from the governor to harvest turkey and deer.
I think I heard him say at one time that when he came here, that, you know, there was no deer that he knew of in Grenada County. And now, you know, by the tracks, I mean, this place is just, it's covered up with them.
The multi-use of the land, it seems to me now, is so important. To grow it, grow timber commercially, but also to grow it in the context of preserving what nature has provided for us. The state of Mississippi is so blessed with its natural setting, its capacity to grow timber, rich land, a lot of water, good rainfall, good climate. So we need to take advantage of that. And that's what we're trying to do here on this place.
Governor Winter's primary objectives for his tree farm are recreation, wildlife habitat improvement, timber production, erosion control, and water quality. Governor Winter did much of the early work on the place, including planting the first tree certified under the tree farm system in 1958. However, because of his active political career, there was a period when he was unable to do extensive field work himself until after his exodus from state government service. Those that know the Grenada County property well think the diversity on the place is outstanding.
You have a mixed stand, natural stand, upland hardwood with mixed pine. You have these old ag fields that have been reforested and put back in timber production.
Through the Georgia Pacific Forest Management Assistance Program and the hunting club leasing his property, Governor Winter has maintained an active tree farm program. He has been involved in both the decision-making and the work.
I have always had a special interest in forestry because, as you say, I grew up with it, and I tried to bring to my public career the emphasis that I felt was appropriate for forestry in this state, which is so important to this state.
State treasurer was the first statewide elected office in William Winter's public career in Mississippi, followed later by lieutenant governor and then governor. Retired Mississippi State University Vice President for Agriculture, Forestry, and Veterinary Medicine, Rodney Foyle, says he first realized the friend that forestry had in William Winter in 1972. Foyle appeared before the Legislative Budget Committee Winter co-chaired as Lieutenant Governor. As Dean of the School of Forestry then, Foyle was seeking $500,000 for a forestry research program at MSU.
Lieutenant Governor Winter, as soon as we were introduced, said, colleagues, I'd like for you all to pay particular attention to this program because I am personally interested in it and hope we'll be able to act favorably on it. And of course, that just greased the skids, and it turned out that the budget committee recommended for funding, the legislature appropriated it, and that was really the first earmarked research money for forestry that Mississippi State ever got.
Years later, Dr. Foyle was asked to serve on the planning team for a unique two-day forestry symposium that then Governor Winter initiated in April 1983. William Winter wanted to see a clear set of goals for the future of the industry.
And so he created this Pathways to Forestry, which became brought together the leaders of the forest industry, of landowners, and laid out a visionary roadmap for the future. The county forestry associations sprung out of that, one of many endeavors, and I think forever changed the business of forestry in this state.
William Winter was not the first member of his family to promote forestry through public service. His father worked on legislation as a state senator in Jackson that created the Mississippi Forestry Commission in 1926. Governor Winter successfully built on the legacy his father handed down, both at the state capitol and on the tree farm in North Mississippi.
These woods we're walking through right now, I played in from the time I was old enough to walk. So what I'm doing now with you is to be reminded of some of those old time that I spent out here, and I don't get to spend enough time out here now.
At age 82, he's still planting seedlings, and he sees forestry as being totally compatible with that long-term view of what's right and good. He sees timber as a God-given natural resource. He recognizes that we're stewards of that resource, and he just like he's devoted his entire life to looking to the future, he does it with his timber business.